a month, the storm clouds have been brewing around the ACC. Earlier this season, inside the muggy pit known as the Cameron, Duke and North Carolina played another classic. Duke had lost seven straight times to the Tar Heels, and they were determined to win one. The player who became known as the Alaskan Assassin pulled the trigger. And the Blue Devils came up a winner. But now, for 32 days, Dean Smith and North Carolina have been unbeaten. But there's one more job at hand, redemption. And there you see the starting lineups at Senior Day in Carolina. So McNary, 7'3", and Serge Zwicker and Tindall step into the starting lineup. Now, Jerry Stackhouse had as teammates at Kinston, North Carolina, Charlie McNary and Webb Tindall. And remember, a year ago for Dean Smith, he started his seniors. They were smoked early by Florida State. They were never able to climb back in it. So let's see what happens now. Jamison is tapping it off. He is on the floor with Shamon Williams and also Serge Zwicker. So, Dick, Carolina does not want to lose momentum early as they did a year ago to the Seminoles.
They were down 10-0 against the Seminoles right out of the gate. But that is a philosophy, and certainly Dean Smith has that concept, utilizes it. He wants to reward those kids that practice every day. I think they'll be in there for about a minute or two.
Now, the Blue Devils go back to work with their small lineup, the one that beat them earlier this year. And their first shot is put down in the turnaround by Rashawn McLeod, who has to play bigger than he is.
He's really been solid all year. He's gotten better and better. He's an inside-outside player.
And Wojo goes out after Tindall, who handles the point. And quickly gives it up to Jameis, gets it back. Tindall's got the shot if he'll take it. In and out, but the rebounder, Jamison, fires it back up, still missing. McNary battles, and Wojo dribble it out now for the Blue Devils. Here is the most improved player, perhaps, in the ACC. Wojo giving it up. McLeod's going to fire again. The three's good.
McLeod showing his inside-outside ability. First possession goes for the block inside. Steps on a perimeter. It's hard for me to believe that St. John's didn't utilize Rashawn McLeod.
So the seniors are back by five here in the early going.
Deja vu again a year later. Against Florida State, we said they were down 10-0.
Now Tindall handles it. Wojo looking for that steal against him.
Beats the ACC in steals with 75.
They go to the ball, tighten it up. Loose on the floor, scramble. Tindall turned it over. His left foot was over the midcourt line, and when the seniors were introduced, Mike Krzyzewski and the Blue Devils were nowhere to be seen.
Psychology 101 of coaching. Mike Krzyzewski showing again, always thinking, trying to be one step ahead of the action. Kept his team on the inside. Here come the starters right now.
18:35 left in the first half, and Carolina brings on the big fellas.
Dean Smith will never break that tradition. He said, I owe it to those kids who practice every day to start them on Senior Day in front of mom, dad, and their loved ones.
Carwell passed up the shot, but Capel won. The three off to the right, and another rebound. This by Vince Carter. What potential he has.
He's really been sensational. He's a tremendous leaper, great legs, very acrobatic.
Okalaja on the drive. Tap back, no. Battle underneath, loose. Duke comes up with it again. Loose ball is going the Blue Devils' way here in the early going.
Wojciechowski, the Rambo man, plays so hard. He's the leader of the club. Just what you said earlier, Brent, he could be the most improved player in the conference.
In and out, and that one winding up in Williams' hands. Shimon now waits to go down low. It'll be Carter off the glass. Kissed it perfectly.
Great decision right there. He posted up the little guy, Wojciechowski, and utilized his great legs to shoot right over the top. Vince Carter is a high riser. I'll tell you though, Brent, their most effective club is when Ed Poeta's on the floor.
Wojo's three. On the money.
He's made 19 threes. He's added that dimension as well in the ACC this year. So if you leave him open, he'll make you really pay.
Now Duke builds an 8-2 lead here in the early going against the Hills, and Okalaja is cut off from penetrating. Zwicker up under the glass for the layup.
You talk about improved players. That guy was labeled a project when he arrived here. Sat out his freshman year, was a red shirt. Worked every day with Eric Montross, Kevin Salvadori. That's the year they won the national title in 93.
Turned it over. Loose.
Look at that hustle. Look at that scrap.
Duke comes up with it, but Carolina gets it right back. And putting it down is Antoine Jamison. All the way for Jamison.
He's an offensive machine. He's had a big 2 years here at North Carolina. Very explosive. I tell you, you can feel that electricity, Brent. You can feel it, the enthusiasm.
Rojo goes three again. Two in a row for him.
The little guy, Mr. Rambo of college basketball. I know Rick Majerus is sitting in our studio. I know he'd love to have a Wojo on his floor.
Oh, great turnaround by Antoine Jamison, one of the great low block players in the college game today because of his quickness.
I like that you use the term low block. So you're an analyst as well as a play-by-play guy.
Capable. Deflected and low now, and there's McLeod, and he's sealed up. Great Tar Heel defense. Comes back though with a wonderful pass on the interior, and Chris Carrawell with his first field goal.
That's been an unsung hero. They went to the smaller lineup against North Carolina. It's the first time they utilized it. And since then, they have won 8 in a row in the ACC. Nice one.
And taking the foul is Jeff Capel.
You know, we talked about the rivalry and the intensity and the emotion and the excitement only 10 miles apart from one another. But we're also seeing excellent basketball right now. Both clubs are really playing well.
Mike Chappelle, who started the last game.
Played big against Maryland, had 10 points. Can make the open three from out of Southfield, Michigan.
Antoine Jamison, to my mind, is one of the best players in the college game today. He's so tough on the offensive glass, Dick, the way he goes with that quickness. He's just a wonderful rebounder. You can just imagine what he's going to be like here in the next year or two.
He's the best offensive rebounder from the small forward slot in America. He has to add a little bit of range to his game.
Chapel Hill, it's a 3-point Duke lead in the early going. Well, Duke this year became the only team in ACC history to go from outright last place 2 years ago to first place this year. This was the key game, Dick, earlier.
Yeah, that really was. Langdon had the big day, knocked down 7 threes to tie a school record of Chris Collins. And also in that game, they were out-rebounded, but they forced 25 turnovers. And that's the key. It helps to negate the rebounding ability of the teams that they play against by forcing a lot of turnovers with their quick lineup.
Duke comes down against the Carolina pressure. Now, Duke is 3 of 4 from three-point land, but so far, Langdon hasn't pulled the trigger. Price will come off the bench and shoot one. He is short. They are now 3 of 5, and the Heels will come right back down. Ed Cota, number 5, is checked in. Here is the most improved Tar Heel during the season. When you look at North Carolina when there was 0-3 in the ACC and what they've accomplished since, it is really something.
Ed Cota
with a tap pass inside, and Duke's defense is equal to the challenge. Newton is checked in. Both coaches using their benches without Newton. Duke beat them last time out. There's an air ball fired up by Chappelle, and the Heels come right back down. They put it in Okalaja's hands.
You mentioned Ed Cota last possession, Brent. He's been the player that's really mature, averaging 7 assists a game in their 7-0 run here in the second half of the season, and only 2 turnovers and averaging 10 points a game. Wow! Wow, that's big with that
caught. The bench with his first field goal of the game.
McIntosh started his career at Wake Forest, went to Michigan, and now starting to get valuable minutes off the bench, defensively especially. That's a big plus when he could score from the baseline with a jump shot.
Duke up by a point.
Ricky Price has been one of the premier 6 men in college basketball. Instant offense, averaging 13 a game the last 7 games.
Chappelle penetrates. On a runner, foul is called against Carolina. Jive.
That was on runner Jive. That's his first.
Watch Maktar right now working the baseline. There he is, going to spin for the baseline. Went to Oak Hill Academy, played with Jerry Stackhouse. You know, we had senior day here, Brent, but where's Rasheed Wallace, Jeff McGinnis, Jerry Stackhouse? Could you imagine what could have been and would have been unbelievable if those three guys were in a lineup?
They're driving their Mercedes-Benz to the closest bank is where they are.
Hey, Rasheed, take it easy up there. P.J. Quarlissimo does a great job. What are we getting on P.J. up there? The guy has discipline. He understands the game. He really is a winner. Leave him alone. There's a guy that's a winner, Dean Smith.
Carolina saves it. Job, give it up now to Cotto, who'll run the floor, and Carolina can tie it or go ahead with the trade. Elijah, number 13, out on top now as they work it back to the left. And you can, both teams feature such great aggressive defensive play.
Point guard play is so important in college basketball. I think who wins this battle wins the game. Wojciechowski or Cote. This is very essential in college hoops. Great point guard play.
10 on that
nice
shot.
Pass.
They get it into Jamison, and he drew the foul. So he'll step up to the free throw line and shoot for the tie.
What a great look by Ed Cote. Really entering the ball at the perfect angle. He's really mature. Take a look now at his numbers. They've really improved tremendously. You look on the right, it's been unbelievable what he has done in the second half of the year. 20 years of age, but he really, chronologically, is 20 years of age, but was limited in basketball experience and great competition.
And that was Wallace, who hacked Jamison. He missed his first free throw, and Zwicker. And Jai sits back down.
Free throw line's really been a problem for North Carolina, with the exception of the last two games. They shot.
Jai was productive as he heads over to Dean's bench, Dick.
Yeah, he goes down. He got a couple good minutes out of him. They shot well on the line against Clemson in their last loss, 24-25.
To Ricks, Duke's ball, leading at 14-12 now. There's the time remaining here in the first half. The Dean Dome in Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Duke has wrapped up the regular season title. They're the number one seed.
Right now, with Wojciechowski out of the game, Langdon's got to become a point guard.
And there is Newton getting the ball on the turnaround for the right baseline, and it's a four-point lead.
I believe he's got to be in the formula, the equation for them to win a national title.
A collision offensive foul has been called against Cota. Wallace took the charge.
Well, Wallace did a great job. What we teach and what we talk about in coaching is hedging. He stepped out, did a great job stepping out into the lane to take the charge. Now watch him right here. See, he jumps out of the screen. That's called hedging. Something you never do. You never hedge. I had to treat you today for brunch. Tell him why.
Nice handicapping last night on the fight. No, but you paid off in a hurry.
Look at this. 60%, 50%. Both clubs very effective. Good offensive efficiency.
Price drops it on into Newton again and goes with the pass to McLeod. Great block down low by Vince Carter, who got a hand on it. Now Williams off the dribble, couldn't penetrate.
They use Zwicker as a relay man up high. They're going to slide him inside.
Away from the ball, Paparo has got McLeod with the personal foul. Dick, one thing about Duke's defense here, they are not giving Carolina the painted area at all on the penetration. They are really cutting them off.
Well, they're doing a great job helping out the interior. That's part of the fundamentals of their defense, is to pressure the basketball and then give help to one another and really try to play the wings really tough as well.
Because keep in mind, Carolina has a huge size advantage. They're better down inside Carolina, but they can't get the ball down there very often. They try this time and throw it up high. There's a pushing foul. It's going to go against Duke, and Price undercut him, apparently.
They tried to throw a diagonal pass to get the lob inside to Jamison. Duke had rotated into a zone defensively. See Jamison wide open? They want to throw the lob. Now here comes Ricky Price, and there he is.
Oh, no question. He got him. He got him with a forearm. He threw it at him.
Carl Hess with the call. Got to be careful you don't undercut a guy and hurt him. Hey, that number one seed wide open now, South Carolina. Congratulations. Dean Smith was singing the praises of his former student, Eddie Fogler, who did a great job beating Kentucky today.
Now, tonight on the network, Lois and Clark, America's Funniest Home Videos, and The Apocalypse Watch is the Sunday night movie here on ABC.
Brent, I was shocked that South Carolina went down to Kentucky and beat them on senior day. What a tribute. I was wrong there, baby. I didn't think they had a shot in a battle down here.
You weren't the only person who was wrong about that. Kentucky was a double-digit favorite at home today. Now, Langdon hits it two, his first field goal of the game. He has been, he's gone from the Alaskan Assassin to the Alaskan Iceman. We're waiting for him to regain his touch.
He was 4-for-18 in the last two games. 3-for-14 against UCLA.
Turnover loose and a foul against Carolina on a breakout that time. They'll assess the personal to Carter.
The officials are really alive here, too. You can see how quick they're making the calls. I like that. They're calling the plays with authority, blowing the whistle quickly.
This Duke team playing with confidence in their step in the early going. They lead it by five. A lot of time remaining. We'll take a break. It is one of the most amazing statistics in sports. For 33 years, North Carolina has finished in the ACC's top three. And remember, this is a team that started 0-3. Then they went to 3-5, and everybody said they're finished. And they're unbeaten since then. Now, earlier today, Virginia, Dick, at 7-9 with that win. Will they get into the tournament?
Yes, because the ACC being such a highly rated conference, they're going to get in. Last year, Clemson got in at 7-9. They'll have six for sure. And if Florida State can beat Wake Forest in the first round of the ACC and win another game, you can see seven out of the ACC. It is a possibility.
Loose on a turnover. Carolina ball. Here's Shamon Williams. He, of course, lit Duke up a year ago in the final game of the season. But he's been quiet so far today. They're able to get Serge Zwicker open on the right side. He wasn't blocked off. Puts in his second field goal of the afternoon. And it's a three-point Duke lead.
He used to be an all-airport player. What an improved player. So active right now. Serge Zwicker doesn't have great foot speed.
Capel's three. Perfect.
Jeff Capel's been an amazing story. You talk about a kid that went to the bench. It was unreal. The crowd began to boo him when he reported against Florida State. And since then, he just kept working. And now he's become a star in the second half of the year.
Zwicker screen on top now for Williams. Okalaja on his right. Into the paint area. It is Jamison, and he gets the roll. And now that's nine for Antoine.
Antoine with that little curl move. It looks like he's headed for a 25-point day.
Capel brings it right into the interior. He puts together two quick field goals, 23-17. Good game.
What an outstanding play right there by Capel, using his great strength. He's a very strong driver. Hey, we have an excellent game going on. The execution's been outstanding.
Jamison, great block down low by McLeod. Just a tremendous rejection for Duke, and the Blue Devils bring it back now. Leading it by six and working on the perimeter. Langdon.
He can shoot it.
Got it.
He can shoot it. He's got the rhythm today, baby. That's the second one he's knocked down.
First one was a two, Dick. He was just inside the line on that first shot.
Well, he heard you talk about the Alaskan Iceman. That was the Alaskan Assassin. There's a look at the three-point shooting.
Big difference, eh?
Yeah, well, Duke lives off that three.
Jamison short. Carter comes back, though, on the follow for the field goal.
He's a special kind of player. He's a super South, getting better and better.
Langdon misses this time, however.
What excitement. Listen to this place. It's got Jamison.
Numbers. Offensive foul is called against Carolina.
Not a good decision. He had Antoine Jamison. You got to go to the big-time scorer right there. He goes to the left. He should have hit the trail man. He gets it to Okalaja, and there's the charge. No doubt about it. Great rotation by Duke. Jamison should have been a guy to touch the ball. Now look at Jamison working inside. See, he's a lot stronger physically than people believe. Nice screen by Zwicker. Horizontal screen and a great block by McLeod. Michelangelo working inside. How's this for a record? 27 consecutive years winning 20 or more games.
Cabo puts it down to the baseline, and he is fouled. Williams fouling.
Welcome back, Mr. Carter. Take a look right now. Wow. Look at after the first eight games. Everything has jumped up tremendously. Had a big game against Wake Forest. 21 in the first half. Threes, dunks.
Langdon battling to maintain the handle. Tied up possession arrow goes over to Carolina.
What spirit. Blue and white. 10.3 miles apart. Look at him diving on the floor, hustling, scrapping. They're going to make the all-John Madden team. Look at this right here. Scrapping, clawing. Wow, I know, Brett, you love that kind of hustle.
Absolutely.
Because you've been a scrapper all your life in the days in Montana.
Cota brings it up now for the heels.
They got to get Swicker some punches inside.
There it is. There you are, Dick. There's your guy touching it down low.
Got to make things happen with the big guy to take advantage of the size difference. I don't think he touches the ball enough on the inside.
No surprise Carroll didn't go for the shot that last time, but regardless, it is rattled in by Wojo, and that's three threes for him today and 9 points.
3 for 3 for Trifecta Land.
They are staying alive outside the arc, these Blue Devils, and they lead it 29-21 as a result. Carolina, for the meantime, has not been able to hit a three because they're making a living down low.
Yeah, they're Swicker down inside, trading 3 for 2. Mathematically, you don't have to go to Harvard to figure that out. Even a dummy like me can figure it out. The three is going to put you up on top, but it better be falling. Duke really,
great Duke defense, Dick.
Yeah, they're really extended. Now go to a half-court trap. There's a diagonal pass.
Williams penetrates right baseline. Foul call. And it is against the Devils on the shot. Williams coming to the line.
North Carolina, you talk about a club that regrouped and really got it all together. Dean Smith did a masterful job getting this club to have a rhythm and a tough conference to be able to win the way they have after starting 0-3. Not only were they 0-3, they were down 9 with 2 minutes to go at home against NC State that they could have been possibly 0-4. Hey, we got to sing the praises of Herb Sender. What a job he's doing at NC State.
Yeah, Herb has done a wonderful coaching job over there with that team. And remember, they had North Carolina reeling when the Tar Heels were 0-3 in the ACC. They should have closed them out that night. As I recall that game, the Wolfpack ran out of timeouts. Couldn't stop it. And once it got rolling for the Heels, they closed them out here in this building. And that started the turnaround.
Herb's won 3 games in a row now.
So we got a timeout with 8 minutes to go. The Dukies living with that 3-point shot today. Timeout.
Payne Weber is proud to announce that Jacques Vaughn from the University of Kansas is their 1997 Scholar Athlete of the Year. Payne Weber recognizes Jacques' commitment to education with a $10,000 donation to Kansas for ongoing research.
I would like to thank Payne Weber for this generous award. Receiving my business degree from the University of Kansas not only acknowledges my intent to excel on the basketball court, but in the classroom as well. Thank you, Payne Weber.
How important is Mike Krzyzewski to the Duke program? Well, remember that without him 2 years ago, they lost 15 of 19 games. They finished dead last in the ACC. This is his 17th year at Duke. He has won 399 games. This would be number 400. Bryce is off with that shot into Zwicker's hands, and now the Heels come back down, trailing it by 6.
We saw the shot selection. You can see the utilization of the threes. The difference here, Duke shooting the three, making 6 out of 10. Carolina has not even attempted one, and the reason Duke has done a great job stretching their defense and extending on a perimeter, pushing North Carolina to have to drive with the basketball and look to the interior. No, you mentioned Mike Krzyzewski, 39 NCAA tournament wins as well, and he was a number one seed on 2 occasions, 1986 and 92, and has a chance to be number one seed again this year. I think they should win in a regular season of this league.
Something he does not talk to his players about is the seeding of the tournament. And I think that's true of most of the big-time coaches in the NCAA. They let that take care of itself. They let the media folks talk about that and let the chips fall. That's about the only way you can handle it.
That's a good conversation piece for all of us to shoot the breeze about. But the bottom line is you still got to win 6 games against good competition to win the national title.
Here's deep to Cota, and Dick, the Heels need Cota to start seizing control of the backcourt out here. You see how they're jumping him and they're really keeping him away from setting the offense up. I mean, they are really hounding Cota out high, all over him. Squeezes it with a beautiful pass, but knocked away and knocked out of bounds. What a fine defensive play That was that Nate James who made that move down low? Yes, it is. That freshman, Nate James, number 14, we don't see a whole lot of him. And that was a very good defensive move down by the baseline.
Well, they went to the half-court trap. They're going to a half-court trap. And what you have to do if you're North Carolina is utilize the post and then look opposite. You got to get the big guy to get touches and step to the basketball. Not a playing man-to-man.
One slipper again against this shorter lineup, trying to go deep, being hounded by this pesky defense. Oak Elijah fires the three in and out. Antoine Jameson with an offensive rebound. That's where Duke is at an enormous disadvantage, is rebounding. They've been out-rebounded for 10 straight games. And, of course, a week ago when their winning streak was broken by UCLA, the Bruins took control of the glass.
Well, J.R. Henderson really hurt him in the second half. He had four offensive rebounds and scores and 16 points on the inside. There's Oak Elijah. He throws a brick, baby. That's Brick City, USA. But it's no brick now. There's Antoine working the glass like the Windex man. And look at the emotion. Look at the jubilation. Dean Smith erupted off his seat on the last possession, and he almost made the call for the illegal screen.
And it was James who made the foul, sending Oak Elijah to the free throw line with the Tar Heels trailing by four.
They found Oak Elijah through Henrik Rodel, who used to play here years ago, playing up in Germany. And he recommended him strongly. They went, looked at him, and here he is playing for Dean Smith. He's got a team that could be all United Nations when you talk about guys like certainly McDoar Jai as well.
Now the whole face of college basketball has been changed because of the interest in basketball internationally. David Stern, the commissioner of the NBA, and those great players in that league have done a lot for promoting basketball internationally now. Duke brings it back down. Langdon goes into that right corner. Price on a pull-up. Tapped up by Newton. Zwicker goes after the miss. He's hit in the face, but he still controlled the basketball. And now Cota brings it down. The three, they're still way off. That was a real air ball.
Well, the right guy's not shooting the three right now. They got to get some threes for Shamon Williams. He's a guy that's a guy that could shoot the three. He's on a sideline right now.
Our guy John Saunders coming up at halftime with Rick Majerus. I certainly hope Majerus is comfortable inside the studio and hasn't gone out looking for those great delis in New York. You know, he's one of the great deli guys in America. I mean, you get Rick Majerus in a delicatessen with Tommy Lasorda, and you may never get out.
Well, I'll tell you, he'll head down to the Carnegie, that's for sure. Nice
and Newton. Great defensive play. Jameson coming over from the weak side. Cota snaps a pass out of bounds. Duke ball, so they give it right back. They don't take advantage of it. It's a two-point game right now. Watch this block at this end.
Well, it's from the help side. There is the great angle for the block. Comes from the help side, Antoine Jameson, but they don't convert. See, there he comes, rotates over from the help side, gets the great angle.
29-27, Duke ball.
Shamon Williams sitting on that sideline as they force a turnover to become big because he can shoot the three. They need his three.
Dick, this may be the most important statistic of this basketball game. Ed Cota is without a single assist here in the first half. I mean, they are attacking the point man of the Heels as he comes across the line. Wojo jumps him right there.
He drives him, beats him, and turns him. Doesn't allow him to make the turn to get into the lane.
They're just denying the Tar Heels access to the low info. So Oak Elijah missing outside, an offensive rebound and a putback from the other side. Finally, he comes up with a shot. So Ed Cota did it with a shot that time.
Well, three times in a row, Galash has shot the perimeter shot, not even close.
Now Cota's got an open man. Here's Jameson. Here's his first assist. And it puts the Tar Heels ahead. 31-29. Phil Ford loving every minute of it.
Jameson can really run the floor. He gets out in transition. Oh, and they're happy here in Chapel Hill. They are jumping with joy, baby. They said, oh, come on. As a number one. Came in from the corner. Now watch Ed Cota come up with the ball. And Jameson has sprinted out already. There is the lead. Jameson with the catch. Jameson with the conversion. And the Heels are on top.
It's a 10-0 run, Dick. And one of the most important things that Cota did was look down the floor. So many times we see youngsters and they don't see the floor when they come out in that situation. He picked up the open man and threw the pass to him beautifully.
He's the third freshman to start here. They had Phil Ford started as a freshman at the point guard slot. And at the other freshman to start was Kenny Smith. There's a look at Phil Ford, one of the greatest point guards ever to play the game.
Dean Smith yelling for some defensive recognition. They've got Capel on the left. He wanted Chamond over there. Instead, it's McLeod takes the three and misses. Rebounding position now going for the Heels. They're starting to dominate the glass. Chamond Williams left side. 5 minutes first half.
They're going to find Chamond. They're going to try to set a screen for him to get a look to shoot the three. He's a 43% three-point shooter and hasn't had any looks yet for three-point range.
Taylor picks it up. Shot clock working down. Drives on Wojo. Inside, and he hits a runner. Oh, baby. What a play by Ed Doda from New York City.
He made a clutch shot against Clemson when they were on the ropes. He beat North Carolina State at the end of the game with a clutch shot. He's
two field goals, Dick, and an assist from Cota, and things have turned completely around when your point man is able to seize control. Langdon fires the three. Got the shooter's bounce.
What an amazing first half. I mean, both teams are really playing so well. I think Cota, without a doubt, will be the freshman of the year in the ACC.
Gets in deep. There's another assist. Jamison in low that time, and that's 15 for Antoine Jamison. 35-32 Heels, 4 minutes, and now it's Duke's turn.
I said a little bit earlier, I thought he was going to have a big day today, Antoine Jamison. Look at the points in the
come off now with another turnover. Williams on the run. The pull-up three, was it?
Yes, he can shoot the three.
There's the three. It's a 6-point lead for Dean Smith and the Tar Heels. Their biggest of the game.
Play with a lot of confidence right now.
Capel fired, but there was a foul called before that, and it's going to go against Duke. That's McLeod.
Uncle Mo has arrived on the side. There's no doubt about it on North Carolina's side. Ed Cota right here comes up with the loose ball. Now he's going to go down the lane. He's determined. There's one thing he's doing here. He's shooting the rock, and he kisses it right on the glass.
So Carter steps up to the free throw line. I'll tell you one thing about good athletes. Don't make a difference what sport it is, horse racing, basketball, matter. They keep coming no matter how much they're struggling out there. And Cota was having a hard time, and he just kept coming and kept coming, and suddenly the game started to turn around for him.
You know, you mentioned the word athletes. We talk about superb quickness, lateral ability, jumping ability. And when you've got athletes, to me, that's such a positive, such a plus. You can do so many things defensively.
Loose circle back. Rattles in.
He's had a big first half, Brent. He really has played so well. The size has been such a factor with him in the interior.
9-point lead. McLeod on the fake with a runner. Finger roll snapped away by Antoine Jamison. Another rebound. Here's Cota now on the right side.
I'll tell you, they're playing as well as any team I have seen thus far this year.
Cota! Oh, brother!
Cota's awesome, baby!
Magic man!
Gotta get a T.O., baby, Mike! Oh, baby, this place is rocking!
Now, in the last 29 meetings between Duke and North Carolina, both teams were ranked in the top 10 16 times. And remember this, folks, the lower-ranked team won 10 of those 16 games. Carolina, ranked lower than Duke, but favored because they're at home, leads it 43-32 on the strength of this run. And again, their defense jumping up in the air, and that was off Jamison's foot. So it's Duke's ball out of bounds. Protect the basketball, partner.
Well, you take a look right here, Brent. The last game, they forced 25 turnovers, Duke, so it can negate the rebounding advantage that North Carolina has. But today, they're not forcing those kind of turnovers, and that has been the difference.
Yeah, Ed Cota, that just tells you how much he has improved. Wojo bluffs three. McLeod cross-court, Capel spotted. Off the fake, inside the arc.
They went to a 2-3 zone right there. It has a little unique setup in that it's not your typical 2-3 zone.
Dick, it's one out. Duke's got to have some offensive rebounds. It's getting too easy now for Carolina and Lowe. That's Carter, and that's 7 points now.
They are really operating so well. Their execution. I've seen a lot of games this year, but I haven't seen anybody execute offensively out of their half-court game and transition game like they are here this afternoon.
McLeod created off the dribble. Duke needed that field goal. It's 45-34, 2-minute mark.
Both clubs so capable of putting spurts on like the spurt we just witnessed by North Carolina. Look at the points in the paint, a 7-1 ratio.
Yeah, see, Cota's getting on the inside now, and it's just an entirely different game with Antoine down in low like that, or it doesn't matter who is down there.
Well, you gotta, anybody. You gotta beat him to the spot. Poor job defensively playing the blocks on the inside. That was a problem for Maryland when Zwicker and Jameson had a field day on the blocks with 53 points on the board against Maryland.
Cable tries to work the baseline and he's blocked. Blocking foul against Carolina.
See, Cota now going to spin off the screen and now watch him dump the ball with a great angle. That's a super bounce pass. The last point guard that I've seen that can make the great bounce passes. We look at the feed inside to Carter, taking advantage of his size. The best I saw feeding a post was Pearl Washington. When he played at Syracuse, he used to be so deft out of getting the ball into that post, a little bounce pass.
Cable. Put it into Curtis' hands again now, and you can see his confidence starting to surge, but he may have turned over the dribble.
Oh, they finally called that. I mean, you can call that 500 times. They finally called that, turning the ball over.
Capello just had to make that call here today.
The pop. Watch it right here. Watch it right here. You're going to see the pop. You're going to see the pop. You see that all the time. Eddie Curtis says, Michael Jordan gets away with it. Michael does it all the time. The greatest ever to lace him up, Mr. Jordan, number 20. The best.
116 now in the first half. Carolina started to hound them. Wojo fires three, though, and that came at just the right time.
Fourth quarter, hit the three-point range. Wojciechowski, a big three.
Back to Cody, plays catch with Okalaja. They go cross now to Williams.
He
Williams
shoot
fire the three. Rattled out, but an offensive rebound, and there he is, Antoine Jameson. That is 19 points for Jameson, and Mike simply does not have an answer for him on the low block, and a lot of other teams don't either. Ojo misses a three, back to him. Here's Capel on the drive. Saves it. Back to Capel, who spotted left side. Rattles it in, so they hit back-to-back trays. Staying alive, down by 9, 49-40.
Staying alive, you sound like John Travolta. Staying alive, baby. I'll tell you, talk about Jameson's first half performance. Rick can talk about Keith Van Horn at 21 last night in their big win over New Mexico.
Now tell Rick why you don't think he should be a number one seed. Tell him what you've been telling me. Come on, Dick.
Hey, Rick,
he's listening to you.
Hey, Rick, he's trying to get me in trouble, Rick.
See, I think you should be there, Rick, but not Dick.
Should have beat Wake Forest at home, baby. He'll tell you. He'll be the first to tell you. I heard Rick on ESPN. He said, we're not that good. But they got great coaches.
Cut the wax of slack. Coming up, John Saunders will be along with the coach, Rick Majerus. 49-40 here, John. We got a good one brewing in Chapel Hill.
Indeed, Brent, with a 9-point lead now. Duke's struggling on the blocks with a difficult time rebounding.
Duke is last in the ACC in rebounding. It's Duke's three guards and their three-point shooting versus points in the paint and a rebounding dominance by Carolina. I like the inside game almost every time in that situation, but you've got to give Duke credit. They've gotten there with imagination and being very creative, but right now Carolina owns them on the glass and dominates them on the block.
They also own a 9-point lead. We'll look at scores and highlights after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
North Carolina spurts the second half of the first half, outscoring Duke 28-11 to take the lead. Dick, not only are the Tar Heels shooting 58%, but they are also out-rebounding Duke big time. But I think it was the little man, Eddie Cota, who turned the game around.
Well, Eddie Cota really made a great, great play at a crucial time in that first half. He started off a little slow. As you can see, he had 4 turnovers early, but then he had 6 points and 4 assists. And the diaper dandy really did a great job attacking and getting the ball inside to Jameson, who, as Rick Majerus said so well, was so effective in the low blocks. Watch inside, there goes the Carter on the interior. Great entry pass. Descota wheeling, dumps it down to Jameson. Duke did a very poor job defending the low blocks. As you watch Carter right now, penetration, and he scores off the glass in the lane. Look at the points of the paint. Unbelievable right there. 30-6. That's a 5-1 ratio in that area. Three-point shooting. I mean, Duke averages 8 threes made a game, which is really high. Number one in the ACC. They already got 9, but it's not enough. Look at Cutter. He's smiling. Don't smile yet. Ed, you got another half to play. This baby's not over.
Neal started the way he started the game. Wojo breaks free on it, and the foul is going to be called against Williams. A little sloppy on the inbounds pass, and Coach Smith is very unhappy about the start here to the second half.
Look at Wojo.
Just holding his head with his hands down there. He can't believe what he was watching down there. He says right in front of me, he's got the man over to the left-hand side. What's he thinking of?
We just showed the scores up there. Wojo has 12. He says, can't they put my name up there? It's Wojciechowski. It's not Wojo. Why did they put Wojo? My name is Wojciechowski. He's the Rambo man.
You get to graduate from Duke if you can quickly spell both Krzyzewski and Wojciechowski.
I'll tell you what, I take you for dinner tonight if you could spell Wojciechowski right now. Spell
I don't have to. All I have to do is bet on the Macho Man against you. And I get to eat. Hey, listen, call me when you're over there in Sarasota, whenever you get the inclination, all right? And don't be giving Albert Bell any of your predictions. You'll bankrupt him.
Uh-oh.
Here's the inbounds pass to Capel.
Uh-oh.
Now they get it in low to McLeod.
Oh!
In his Rooker's hands.
Nothing like size. Right there again, you see Serge Zwicker with that rebound. 7'3", they have no answer. See, I think the first 4 minutes right now at halftime, I've said this so often, especially in a situation like this, you're on the road, you need a spurt here, Duke, to get that confidence back.
Okolaja standing on the line, there's no question that's a turnover.
Yeah, well, the ball and man were over the front court area, and then he went back, so it was definitely a good call. Duke players made the call as well. They got to find some screens and get Langdon some looks at the goal. Ball and man are both over, and then they go back.
Looking on the perimeter.
Screening away from the action.
Here is Langdon, and Jamison had him. Capel works the baseline. Ships Wojo. McLeod plus three. It's a nice penetration move as he stepped inside the arc, and that's 9 points for the former St. John's player.
I really like Rashawn McLeod because he gives them that kind of player that can go inside, outside, and they don't have a whole lot on the interior. Most of their point production comes from the perimeter or from dribble penetration. Zwicker, throw it inside. There it is. Oh, score it. Score it. Good call. Good call. Mike Wood with the call. No doubt about it. Interference up there on a basket. There's the lob inside. Now watch the rotation over. You cannot play with the ball off the glass in college basketball. Good call. NBA, you can get away with that. In college basketball, you cannot take it off the glass. Especially in a situation where it's right now, it's on its way.
Langdon's coming to the free throw line.
Ball was on its way down. You cannot interfere it off the glass on its way down.
Well, that's coming your way next week. ABC's Professional Bowlers Tour moves to California with the AC Delco Classic, then World Speed Skating Championships coming up on Wide World Sports.
Right
and
now,
along with the NutraSweet World Challenge of Champions.
Excuse me, Brett, but right now, Langdon on that live is usually automatic. He's like the number one free throw shooter in the ACC, makes like 90% of his free throws. He's an outstanding baseball prospect. He's with the Padres. I told Caminiti about him, but Caminiti never heard of him. I talked to him at the ESPY Awards. He's a third baseman. I said, Langdon, please, forget about third base. You'll never play with Caminiti. Jamison right now, they're going to try to slide him inside. I got McLeod matched up with Jamison. Look at the size advantage Zwicker has against Carawell. I mean, that's an Eminem mismatch. Throw it inside to him. 7-3 on 6-6.
Dota against the shot clock's got two, he's got to hurry, and he traveled. Goes to Duke, good defense by the Blue Devils. They trail it 51-43 and a chance to cut into that lead.
See, not a good job there in their offensive execution. Look at Zwicker, 7-3. He wants the rock. He says, please get it to me. Rick Majerus get it to his guy Doliak inside with a mismatch.
Carawell does cut into that lead with the jumper from the right baseline.
I like it. Went to Cardinal Ritter High School in St. Louis. Played with Lauren Woods. They won two state championships back-to-back. Woods with Wake Forest.
Off Okalaja's hands, and now the Devils can put together a little bit of a run. Williams checks into the lineup for the Tar Heels, who come out here and they're just a little bit flat in the start of the second half. Not playing with the same intensity that they finished up the first half. There's no question about that.
Last meeting. Look at the numbers in your last meeting. Boy, there's nothing like emotion. If you play with emotion and intensity, you'd be shocked what you can produce.
Good ball. See 21 seconds on the shot clock above the basket there.
I guarantee you those kids of South Carolina went down to Kentucky today and played with a lot of emotion. No one gave them a shot. There's a guy with emotion, Mike Krzyzewski.
Carawell, beautiful move inside.
Tell you, he's not playing like a diaper dandy, I can tell you that. He's very strong physically, tough kid.
That's a 4-point Carolina lead, and Duke starting to whittle away now. Williams gets inside Dakota off the glass. And a little man able to get it back somehow amidst the trees. The way he stays with it on the paint has been remarkable today. 8 points.
I tell you, what a little offensive rebounding job done right there by Ed Cota. Out of New York City, went to St. Thomas More Prep School in Connecticut.
Rattles out. Jameson's rebound. Now the Heels can put together field goals.
Swicker, throw it up high to him. Throw it inside to Swicker.
Okalaja's fourth three, and he has got the goose egg working on the outside.
I cannot believe they have not given the ball inside to Zwicker as you watch Cota working on the inside, number five. Little Ed Cota, there he is with a head fake. Now he goes up again, comes back again with the offensive rebound. See, work hard, good things happen. The ball fell right in his hands because he kept working.
Now for the Devils. They are penetrating in that paint. And jump ball is called. It is Duke ball possession arrow.
Capel did a great job of beating right there, beat Jameson to the basket, but Zwicker rotated over and gave him a lot of help. There's nothing like helping recover defensively.
McLeod wants to go to work.
Offensive foul on McLeod.
He traveled. They called traveling, Dick. Caparo had traveling on the other side.
Oh, he got the walk first, the walk to precedent before the charge.
16-20, left in regulation, 53-47. Carolina lead, and here comes Cota up on Wardrow.
Dean Smith closing that margin to become the winningest coach in the history of basketball. 876 is the number.
Just a matter of time. Could happen this year. They get on a run in that ACC tournament, I'll tell you that. Zwicker. Carolina stay with it, and Zwicker comes right back, and there he is. 55-47.
Finally gets some touches inside to the big guy. It's not like he's a project. He's got good hands and he's got good touch.
Capel's three, not there.
Oh, Jameson.
Offensive rebound, and here's Jameson runs a foul. Rojo took the foul.
Intentional. That should have been intentional. Should have been intentional. Should have been two shots of the ball. A breakaway layup. You take a look at Jameson, there's no doubt in my mind that was intentional.
15-42. Dean Smith says, are you kidding me? Time out. Up on ABC. Here it is, North Carolina with the basketball and a 55-47 lead over Duke right now with 15:40 to go in regulation. And Okalaja travels. It goes over to Duke.
Now watch right here. Here's Jameson. And there it is, the grab, trying to stop him from the transition layup, the easy layup. I know the argument they'd make is he was going for the ball, but I thought the intention was there in terms of trying to stop him for that layup and grabbing him. Look at the offensive rebounds, North Carolina, 3-1 ratio. That means you're playing aggressive basketball.
Off the bench, Ricky Price.
Where have you been?
Quiet, hits a three, and that cuts the margin to five, and there's backcourt pressure from Wojo.
Wojo and Cota going at it. Wojo looking for the screen.
That was Wallace jumping out on, I can't believe no foul is called on that side.
Dean Smith can't believe it either. He's a rake. He thinks that Jameson's been
Zwicker to the glass. And the foul is called. But I'll tell you, I've never seen Dean as animated as he was on the sideline just a moment ago with Antoine being bumped over there.
There's another bump. Look at Dean, as you said, I haven't seen him that animated on a sideline. He's got 871 wins, but he wants 872, baby. He said, we were undefeated, he told me, in February, but I want to be 1-0. I want to be 1-0 in March.
Deep Dakota. That foul was called. So it is a 5-point Carolina lead. They have the ball.
Wallace is in as a defensive stopper to play against Jamison. No one's been able to contain him down inside. They get a switch.
Williams loses. Langdon jumps all over it. Loose on the floor. Cota comes up dribbling and penetrates. Great pass. Oh, what a pass. Antoine Jamison.
What a great look. Tremendous vision by Ed Cota. He'll be the diaper dandy of the year in the ACC, baby.
Langdon fires the three, rattles out. Zwicker for the rebound, yanks it away.
I really admire that kid. His great work ethic to make himself a player, Zerv Zwicker. Jamison posted again. He can't handle him. Can't handle him. It's another number. It's a mismatch, baby. It's like having a great beauty contest. And here comes Cindy Crawford in her bikini. And here comes Roseanne in her bikini. A no contest.
Now that is some slight 59 to 50. Rojo rattles out. Newton saves it for him. Rojo now penetrates, gets it into Newton's hands, and the foul is called. No basket. It's against Zwicker before the shot.
Now watch Jamison getting his 1,000th point. 12th guy to get a dunk in less than two complete years within a team system. Remember, in North Carolina, they have balance, so they have the team system, and there's the 1,000th point. Jam City.
Jamison is 10 of 14 for the floor, and if he returns next year for North Carolina, and there doesn't seem to be the reason why he shouldn't, he is going to be a leading candidate for the player of the year next year. He is a wonderful basketball player. Capel hits the three.
He's not so bad either, Jeff Capel, with that long-range three trifecta. Carmen Wallace is really trying to muscle Jamison, and Jamison holds post really well inside.
This time, Williams missed after penetrating, and Newton lost control. Carolina ball.
Jamison from out of Charlotte, North Carolina, signed early with Dean his senior year. Had a great year last year, made the All-ACC team as a freshman.
Dick, you know, it's kind of interesting that despite the fact Carolina's outplayed Duke, and we would all agree with that, Duke is still hanging in the neighborhood. Down only six, they've got the bevy of three-point scores. They get Langdon or Capel or Wojo going here. They jump right back in this one. They're 11 of 23 from three-point land. So they're staying alive outside the arc is what they're doing.
Now they're zoning right now. They go to a zone in that possession.
Carter comes up against it, rattles out, and finally the rebound winds up in Price's hands.
Very difficult to get away from Duke. They hang and hang because they're so tenacious. And they can make the three. Anytime you can do that, you got a chance to get back in game. There's
Here's
another
Price.
A legal screen on Wallace. A legal screen on Wallace's ball.
That's his third personal foul, Vic.
Coach K can't believe it. Certainly a candidate for Coach of the Year in the ACC and a Coach of the Year candidate nationally as well. I think Clem Haskins deserves the National Coach of the Year. I'd cast my
I think
there.
Eddie Fogler does at South Carolina. I hate to disagree with you, but I just think today, Dick, was a monster win.
No question. You could make a great point for Eddie Fogler, but if you look wire to wire and what he's achieved at Minnesota, I'm going to go for Haskins.
Great pass to Williams, but he traveled.
Our guy in the studio should get some votes. Rick Majerus, I don't care who you are. Anytime you can win as many games as they win, the same with Roy Williams. As we look right there, trying to run a backdoor cut. Little slip. There's a look right there. Controlling the ball. We take a look right there. Rebounds, turnovers.
Price will go for the first one. Just can't find the touch. McLeod tried to run it down. Could not. Carolina ball.
Carolina not really having a lot of turnovers like they did in that first matchup. 25 turnovers Duke forced. They did the same thing against Maryland. Their defense really drove Maryland bananas and created all kinds of turnovers.
You do not want to draw Carolina in the NCAA tournament. I'm going to tell you that right now.
Well, you don't want to draw Duke either.
Well, this size deck of Carolina. Carter rattles it out. I think Duke has to play at such high intensity to stay in the game because, as Rick Majerus was saying at halftime, they just don't have the manpower down on the low blocks.
But they really play with that intensity and with that three-point weapon.
Booker stepped it out.
Duke's not going away in this game, Brett.
No,
I'm telling you, they're fighters, they're scrappers, they reflect that guy on the sideline, the former West Point cadet, Michael Kay.
Four fouls on Carter, and that's a big number. Timeout. Carolina leading Duke by 6, 59-53, and we've got Auto Racing doubleheader coming your way next Sunday here on ABC. First, the cars of NASCAR. That's the Primestar 500 at the Atlanta Motor Speedway. Dale Earnhardt is the defender there. Then at 5 Eastern from Daytona, the International Race of Champions. Coming up next week.
What a super moment it's going to be at that ACC tournament. Can Wake Forest bounce back? They lost to Florida State. They hook up with them again. Pat Kennedy needs a win. It's going to be incredible. They have not had a field goal. Wow, since the 14-10 minute mark. Wow.
There's Price. Great leaping ability off the penetration after the timeout. Cuts back into it, and now it's a four-point Carolina advantage. And Dick, you're absolutely right. Duke not going away at all.
I like Ricky Price's legs. He really gets a bounce out of his jump shot.
Williams is pushed on the penetration.
I think they've done a great job controlling Shamon Williams, an outstanding shooter. Ricky Price has really stepped up the second half of the year, just like Jeff Capel. Nothing like having experience. He and Capel together last year averaged 30 points a game, went to the Pine early this year.
Deflected on the inbounds pass. That's Antoine Jamison taking the ball out of bounds. McLeod is pressuring it with a long reach for Coach K.
Brett, you really tell a lot about a kid's character when he gets sent to the sideline after being a leading scorer and he comes back strong.
Got away with one. Banged the defender off of him and hit the field goal.
That's a quick way of getting rid of the defender.
Here comes Price now. He's starting to take over offensively. Score it. And a chance to complete the three the old-fashioned way.
Look at that emotion. Look at the passion, the love he has for playing the game. He didn't go to the sideline and cry and moan. Now look at Antoine right here. Jamison. Oh, Newton with a little acting job. I mean, he wants to win the Academy Award. He wants to be Tom Cruise. Show me the money. Show me the money. And there's Ricky Price. Says, show me the basket, baby. I understand up there in Utah, they got Rick Majerus. And when everybody's going to be coming after him now, until his jobs open up, they're going to show him the money. That's you. See, they show
Price
you the money.
Price completes the three, and it's 61-58 now. Carolina 11-14 here, Dick. And Duke picking up the intensity. I think it is Price who has given him a huge lift right now.
A big-time lift, no doubt about it. But a lot of pressure on a basketball as well. You must really try to control Carolina right out here on the perimeter. And that's what Wojciechowski's trying to do.
Elijah, left-handed dribble, gets to the baseline to give it up on the other side. Shot is missed. Loose on the floor. Elijah goes scrambling. Rojo back with it. They're going to call a jump ball, and I believe Carolina retains possession.
If Wojciechowski was a little bit bigger,
shaking up, Dick.
What a linebacker he would be.
And quickly, they receive some medical attention down on the floor. So,
I couldn't see what happened there, Brett.
It looked like McLeod bumped his head.
Get a stretcher. From a great high school program.
And Mike Krzyzewski's yelling to get a stretcher.
Get some help out here. Get a doctor. Get out here.
Out of St. Anthony's, a beautiful place.
You know, I'm not. Krzyzewski is yelling for an ambulance and a stretcher right now. And Dick Paparo clearing the benches.
I never like to speculate in situations like this since we're not medical people and we're not close to the scene here.
We need a towel. We need a towel covering up.
did not see it in that replay, but it looked like, according to people telling us, that he definitely made contact with his head to the floor.
That is the University of North Carolina team surgeon out there, Dr. Tim Taft, who went immediately out to assist. And we'll return with more action from Duke and North Carolina right after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Well, the good news is just moments ago, Rashawn McCloud up under his own power walking off. He gets cut inadvertently. I believe it's his teammate Newton who accidentally rakes across the top of the head. You can see as you watch over and over while you were gone, as McCloud goes down, he even seems woozy as he's hit on the top of the head. And I think that Mike Krzyzewski's reaction, which you heard when he was out on the floor saying, get a doctor and get an ambulance, there was blood on the floor and it has been cleaned up. And this was the scene just a few moments ago as he had been helped off to the sideline. He got a nice ovation here. Chapel Hill, and now the floor is being cleaned there in the painted area. And I really wouldn't be surprised if we won't speculate whether or not he's going to come back or not, but he's going back toward the Duke locker room.
I thought it was a classy gesture of all the Tar Heel fans. Gave him a standing ovation. So beautiful. I know his family could be a little bit more relaxed now back in New Jersey. From out of St. Anthony's High School, played for Bob Hurley in that great program, and he walked off, and it looked like it was a cut on the eye.
So it'll be Price and Newton along with Wojo and Capel on the floor for Coach Krzyzewski after that timeout. 55. Dean Smith, Jamison, Okalaja, both of them out there. Williams will take the ball out of bounds. Cota is on the floor.
It's a big loss. They lost an inside-outside player. McCloud is so needed because of the advantage that North Carolina has with its inside game. Newton now has to become a big-time factor. Newton has to really step up for Duke.
Williams fires the three. Okalaja misses. Tap back. Good.
See, right there is an advantage. On the offensive glass, they have no one to rebound other than Mr. Newton right now with McCloud out of the game.
Duke can't respond. Carolina controls. It's one and out. Numbers, Cota, two on one. Beautiful pass to Williams. Great block, however. And that was number 23. Chris Carawell rejected that shot.
What you have now is a situation where you don't have the rebound and advantage as Cota gives the little dish off to Shamon Williams, his backcourt mate. There's the rotation over in the block shot. You got to make up for your lack of rebounding prowess by doing a job defensively and forcing turnovers, and offensively make some threes.
Checks in here.
Oh, yeah, the big guy.
See the picture, and Newton will sit down.
Look at the offensive rebound totals.
This shot was wide open. Got right in Domzalski's face on the first play after the substitution.
Domzalski was out a long period of time this year with a knee injury.
Langdon also back for the Devils.
They're playing Langdon really tough. They're going to let some hard screens for him.
Traveling.
Duke really has to regroup right now. They look a little bit out of rhythm. There's a man knows a little about winning seven times to the Final Four. There's the jam on the inside. Maktar Jai. He's giving him some positive minutes today off the bench.
Carolina builds a seven again. 9:37 left in regulation.
Domzalski really laying a forearm on Zwicker. Can't handle him.
Jamison. Jamison. Back door.
I can't believe how free he gets. You would think they would be aware of him on the floor.
Zwicker. Here's Williams.
There's Jamison again.
Jamison runs the floor beautifully and missed the shot.
Really fills the lane exceptionally well. He's like a thoroughbred in transition. He's like Pulpit, the young little horse. Pulpit.
On a pass inside for the field goal. Yeah, Dick Pulpit, you mentioned him, might be the favorite at the Kentucky Derby, the way he's flashing his form down in Florida.
Duke's got to come up with a defensive stop. They got to find a way to give some help on Jamison, having a field day on the inside.
Spinning move by Cota. They hit Jamison again.
Score it.
And he'll come to the free throw line. Antoine Jamison.
He's putting a clinic 101 on how to play in the blocks inside. Lock in position, getting the good drop step angle, the quick release once he catches the ball. What a clinic he's putting on how to play the post. And Eddie Cota says, I'm going to get those assist totals up. And he leads them perfectly. Throws it right at the perfect angle. There he is running the floor now. Look at him right now. Sneaks behind the defense. How's he wide open? It's beyond me, Brett. Somebody got to tell him that kid's a superstar. These clubs beat up on each other like you can't believe. The emotion, the effort that's exerted in this conference. Most of the year, they've had four teams in the top 10, 30 points, 9 rebounds.
Whistle for the shot, Cota. They
really miss Rashawn McCloud, his strength, his experience. They're thin to start with on that baseline. Back-to-back national titles, 91-92 for Coach K. Brent, I think there are about 15 teams in America that can win 6 games in a row and win a national title, and these are 2 of them.
There's the 3 from the corner, and it came at the right time. Mike Chappelle.
Trajan Langdon's got to get some looks. He had 7 trifectas in the first matchup. They got Wallace back, the defensive stopper run.
And Williams responds with a 3 at the other end.
Where has he been? He can flat out shoot the rock, baby. Nothing but nylon. Oh, and they dancing. They are going bananas here.
Langdon goes inside for the rebound. Misses on the putback. Jamison goes sky, and a foul is on Wallace.
Nick Vaccaro with the call before the jump ball was called. Gets Wallace, but bodying up on Jamison.
4 personals on Wallace.
Wallace has had all kinds of knee problems in his career. A senior, good role player. Look at Jamison, up over the glass. What a big-time performance he's having. What a big-time performance. Rebound totals are amazing. We thought that. 37 of 14. It's amazing they could even be in a game having those totals so out of whack.
Blocking foul on Duke.
North Carolina really doing a great job attacking gaps with dribble penetration and looking for open men. Michael Cade, a winner of the ACC this year, regular season. Dean Smith, as you said earlier, an amazing number. 33 years in a row, 1, 2, or 3 in the ACC. Wallace goes to the sideline, fouled out trying to check Jamison.
And Carter, as a result, shoots 4-1.
He's been quiet. Vince Carter's been quiet.
Domzalski back out on the sideline, and Newton has returned for Coach K.
They'll have some size next year when Chris Burgess arrives at about 6'11". Elton Brand, who's a man from Peekskill, New York, and Shane Battier as well. But Mike Krzyzewski and his kids aren't thinking about next year. They're thinking this year.
Carowell.
Now, how do you keep Jamison off an All-American first team? I got him in my top 10, but I can't put him across the front. Not with LaFrance, and certainly with the big guy Duncan, and you got to have Keith Van Horn, multi-dimensional. Rick's special player.
Interesting that the Blue Devils went flat after the McLeod injury. Seemed to take a little something on them. They were mounting a pretty good comeback, and now Carolina has built a 12-point lead here with 7:15 to go.
It really hurt them on a glass in particular. If there was one guy that could help them on a glass, it was McLeod, even though that strength certainly belongs to North Carolina. Well, they've been out-rebounded, as we said, 10 consecutive games. Jameson gonna get a little rest now.
Well, either that or there's some blood over there, Dick. And he's cut. I believe that's why he's going off on the side. He'll go back into the Carolina locker room. Remember that Duke had pulled to within 3 points. It was 61-58 when McLeod was injured, and you can see the reaction of Jameson that he was injured, so he's out, and Duke will see if they can make some hay with Carolina's big man out now. 7:08 here. They go for the three, and they have got it, and I'm going to tell you, that's a couple of big threes for Mike Chappelle. He's the freshman from Southfield, Michigan.
He can shoot. He's got range. Duke picking up, trying to pressure the basketball. Your size is not a factor if you can apply a lot of pressure and get them out of their execution. Now they don't have the box effectiveness inside without Jameson.
So Zwicker, and Newton jumps him. Gets a turnover call, stepped on the line before the timeout. Tried to call timeout, did not call it in time. So the ball winds up back with Carolina.
Both these clubs very young. They're certainly going to be two of the best teams in America next year. Look at Mike Kay. Told me today, 17 years he's lived in this area. He has never walked down Franklin Street here in Chapel Hill.
We're told that McLeod received 3 stitches. Not likely that he'll return today, but he is fine. He received 3 stitches. And it is, progress is good there. It's Jameson who has returned after getting some medical attention. And this is a different Carolina team when number 33 steps back on the floor. He reminds you a little bit sometimes of James Worthy down low, the way he gets to the glass with the offensive rebound. Great steal by Cota. Great one-handed pass. Easy deuce for Leo.
Little reverse jam, little showtime. Get the mustard out, baby. Little pizzazz, little hot dog-ish. Have a little fun.
And Wojo hits the tray. 15 points for him now.
Carolina, I can't get over the improvement of this team from the club I saw earlier this year. What a different basketball team.
That's a tribute to Dean Smith and his coaching staff. This is a very well-coached team.
Look at Zwicker's passing ability. Double up on him, and he finds immediately the open man. And now a little showtime. Here goes Shamon Williams. He says, look at me, I'm a little guy, but I got some hops, baby. I got some rising ability. Wow. I wonder if Rick Majerus can get up like that. You think John Saunders and Rick can get up like that? Get him a ladder, they might.
You know, it's interesting with Phil Ford over there, how hard they must have worked all year with Cota. And you've got to give Cota a lot of credit for listening. He has learned. He is so much improved over the course of a season as he steps to the free throw line. 11 assists here so far. A 10-point Carolina lead, 5:53. And remember, they were jumping all over the freshman in the early going. So McLeod has returned following the injury. You may not have recognized that number. We saw at the bottom of the frame. They had to change the jersey because there was blood on his.
Duke's got to get some threes. They live by the three.
Langdon loses it.
Great hustle by both clubs.
Dakota Tapper, but right back to Price. Now Carolina ball coming down. Numbers, Carolina.
Go to
Cota
Jameson.
The floor. Gets it inside. Rolls it up off the glass. And Cota.
A star is being born here, baby. Eddie Cota becoming a star in Chapel Hill. Oh, what a great basketball environment. Tobacco Road, nothing like it.
Needs threes down the stretch. Price misses. Carolina ball. Got a blocked pass, and now he'll take some seconds down off the clock.
He's playing with such confidence. He's got that strut now. Like, I belong. I know I'm special now. This is becoming my team. This game has been so highly paced. The tempo's been unreal.
Air ball. Duke ball.
Look at that scrapper. Look at that hustle. Look at this. Look at Jameson running the court. And Eddie Cota's going to finish it.
Duke today with 14 of 20.
29 trays, but they have been badly outscored in the paint. They have been out-rebounded, and as a result, Carolina leads it 82-69. Championship week started yesterday on ESPN, and that will continue with 28 conference championships just about time.
I can't wait to get up there Wednesday. I hope they got the seat for me. Guys like Chris Fowler, my buddy Dickie, Mr. Phelps, Richard Phelps and company. Hey, I want to salute Dale Brown with his big win in his last game, but more than that, the end of his career as we look here at the top 25 in America.
Well, we see that what's important now is what happens to the 4-1s. Kansas certainly along with Minnesota, but everything else becomes a bit of a jump ball with both Wake Forest and Kentucky losing. You heard Coach Majerus saying that needs a little help, needs to win the WAC tournament, and then they'll have a chance at a number one. Very wide open year, and Wojo rattles in another three. That's 18 points for the little man.
He's done a real great job shooting that three today. The big difference is defensive ability inside on the blocks has not been there for Duke.
Pounding it and barely stepped out of bounds.
No, forced a 5-second turnover there, because if you hold the basketball, the 5-second count is in effect. If you dribble it, it is not.
It's not, right. You're right, Dick. So it's 82-72, North Carolina. Up by 10 with that three, and these shooters for Duke, it is not yet over. Let me tell you that. Capel on a penetrating move, and he is fouled. Foul is against Wicker, so Capel brings himself to the free throw line. This is another part of the strategy that Duke would have to employ to battle back in this game. Plenty of time left at 4:12.
They rotated Jamison out on Wojciechowski. I think it was during a switching situation. What intensity down here, I tell you. It's unbelievable. The intensity in this conference, the environments are special. And I was mentioning Dale Brown. I want to just certainly get this out. Dale finished 25 years of coaching. It was very emotional yesterday. He had that win over Arkansas. And he's brought a lot of good memories to the people down at LSU and Baton Rouge. And we wish him the best in whatever he does.
Absolutely. Capel misses his second.
He's going to be working. He's going to be working with us a little bit over at ESPN as well.
Wonderful character. Williams brings it down now across the midcourt line. Wojo hounding it.
Look at Wojo. There's no quitting that little guy. There's no quitting that little guy. See, a couple of years ago, he couldn't do that. It would be a 5-second count. But right now, as long as you dribble the ball, you can run it out.
And they're going to get Wojo. That's his third foul.
Dean going for number 872. Look at Wojo trying to beat him to the spot.
Now watch Wojo. His father was an outstanding soccer player. Now watch here. You see that? That's what you do. Keep it going. Now watch his feet. You see? Yep. Oh, and a little knee. Got away with that. Still not done. No, take that.
Tripped him.
He tripped him. Oh, yeah. The son of a soccer player would know how to do that all along. 3:45. Finally got it on the third one.
He probably should be a soccer player, Wojciechowski. Wow. Looks like a soccer guy.
I believe his brother was an outstanding soccer player, as I recall also in reading about the family, Doug. 3:45, 10 point, make it now 11. Williams with the free throw. So we've got a timeout. Coach K and Duke, they need some three-point firepower the rest of the way in this one. Timeout. Great environment here, and our thanks go to our producer Kim Belton and our director Drew Esikoff and this wonderful ACC crew that covers basketball as well as any crew that I have ever been around. Also our executive producer Steve Anderson, who has worked alongside Dick Vitale for many, many years. Nice to have you along, and nice job by our crew as we bring down the final 3.5 minutes here on ABC's coverage of regular season college basketball. Doesn't get any better than what we see in the ACC on a week-to-week basis. Capel on a runner miss, and the foul is going to go against the star of the game, Antoine Jamison down underneath.
Well, you know, you mentioned our producer, Kim Belton, our executive producer. Both guys, Steve Anderson and Belton, love basketball. They both were scholarship players. One at Stanford, Mr. Belton, and the other at Holy Cross.
Did you recruit either of them?
I tried to recruit both of them. I was 0-2, baby. 0-2. But you know what? I lucked out not recruiting my guy Anderson because he was Pine City when he went over to Holy Cross. Belton, I wish I had him, but I couldn't compete with the guys up in Cardinal country.
84-73, Carolina. Now with the lead, and Newton and Duke with time left. The three-point play, I know it's controversial, but one thing it does in a situation like this is it leaves you in the ballgame for a long, long time. Especially with that high arc, Dick.
Especially the way they can shoot the three, Mike Krzyzewski's club. They can knock down a bunch quickly if they can force some turnovers with their defense. I'll tell you one thing about Anderson, though. He knew his basketball. I should have just recruited him to sit next to me and help me.
And Newton hits both free throws. So they've cut into that 10-point lead again with 3:27 to go. And speaking of the trifectas today, Mike Chappelle hit a couple of them. They've hit 15 Duke has today, 15 of 30.
That's amazing. And they're only down three possessions the way they can shoot the ball. If they can get some stops here, they got to find a way to stop Jamison inside. Now they rotate Ricky Price on him. I can't get over how strong he is on a box inside. He's so wiry. You look at him physically, you think you can push him out of there.
He's got that basketball quickness and that great sense when he runs the back door.
And he's got that great athletic ability.
Kota penetrates left hand, but Zwicker, offensive putback. The other big man was all size.
Size, 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 baby. You can't teach 7'3".
Price comes back to the three, and he picks up one on the exchange. Score it. And if they also got a foul here, yes, it's good, says Paparo. And Jamison picks up the personal.
Could be a four-point play right here, Brent. Big possession.
Dean Smith just kind of like shaking his head like, you believe this?
Well, Dean knows also getting a little hot in here. A little Mailox type. Look, we're doing a little dance for us. He's got those Armani specials on. Now watch right there. There's the jump shot. Then they must have had a foul on the inside.
They're hitting 1-on-1 also. This could be a five-point play down away from the shot. Now watch Langdon.
Oh, there's the foul down on the box inside. They called a push on him.
A five-point play puts the Blue Devils right back in the thick of it. They're only down six, ladies and gentlemen, with 2:45 to go.
And they've scrapped and clawed. There's no quit. Both these clubs will not
open. Is Carter. They missed him. Foul is called. In that situation, it was a good foul to take. He was all alone down to the left side of the glass.
Wide open, a breakdown defensively by Duke. They went into a trap, and now look, a wide open is Carter. Lack of communication, but there's the contact. There's Zwicker kicking it out.
Langdon was able to get across, commit the personal. Carter did not score the field goal and misses. So, for Langdon, that's a great foul now at 2:37 and down six.
Well, you know, they only shoot 65% as a team on a free throw line. That's been a problem, but the last two games they've shot well, 20-for-25 and 20-for-24.
Now it's a 7-point advantage, and Wojciechowski brings it down for the Blue Devils.
Langdon, gotta find a shot for Langdon.
Capel's got the glass. Missed the shot, and little Ed Kota dribbles out with the rebound.
He's got to manage the clock now, bring the ball back out, play intelligently, get that basketball IQ to start the move. Work.
Some of Ed Kota's biggest plays in this game have been rebounds, offensively and defense. Five rebounds for the smallest man on the floor. Now it's Williams bringing time down. Price jumps it, loose. And coming up with a steal is Price for the Blue Devils.
Langdon for the shot.
Langdon penetrates. Kicks now. Here's the three. Capel scoring. Oh, baby, they're right back.
Penetrated pitch. Nothing like the three-point shot. It's revolutionized college basketball. Here's an example. They're living by the three.
It's now a four-point game because of this. Watch this play on the great pass. Langdon penetrates and dishes back outside, the inside outside.
He was the 3P man then. He penetrated, he pitched, and points. The 3Ps, Brent Musburger. Hey, it's been great all year working with you. I've had a lot of fun working with guys like you and Mike Patrick and Brad Nessler. I'm a lucky, lucky guy.
I've enjoyed it very, very much, Richard. 87-83, let me tell you something. Not over yet. 1:51, we'll take a break.
Toughest, smartest army in the world. Be all you can be. Gossamer Bay Vineyards. Wine with a taste that's meant to be shared. and Canon Laser Color. Its only competition is reality.
One of the great settings in college basketball, Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Tar Heels hanging on, and Duke with a school record 17 three-point baskets today, hitting 17 of 32. And you can see the way it offset that rebounding edge that the Heels have. Cota on the penetration. Now Williams will go three, missing. Duke runs it down. They're only down four right now, 87-83, and a lot of time remaining. Langdon sealed up by Williams. Will fire the three. Missed it.
Not a good shot right there. He forced that three-point attempt.
Carter comes up with it, and they put it into Cota's hands. 119.
Got to manage the clock now. Basketball IQ. Get it back out. Smart play by Shamon. Not really the shot that Trajan wanted. He's excellent when he shoots that three within their offense and within the movement of the basketball. Could get down to free throw shooting. North Carolina shooting 65% as a team. Look at Wojciechowski. Look at the stance defensively.
Cota can bring it out. Eight on the shot clock, and now they got to hurry. Inside to Jamison. And it goes over on the foul call. Jamison caught the ball, turned around.
He pulled it
on Jamison. The foul call goes against Jamison.
For an offensive foul on Jamison. Big possession. Antoine can't believe it.
Dick Vitale, I'm Brett Musburger. Inside of a minute to go, North Carolina clinging to a four-point lead. Wojciechowski picks it up for the Blue Devils. They bring it down in front of the Blue Devil bench. They've made 17 threes, looking for number 18. Can't get it. Carter's got it. Foul on Duke at 39 seconds to go. And the Heels will come up and shoot free throws.
Last possession has not really, last two possessions has not really been what Mike Krzyzewski likes. I can tell you that. They made a gutty comeback here with their defensive tenacity of making those threes.
How good are these two programs when you view college basketball? Well, consider this. From 1986 to 1994, Duke and North Carolina made a combined nine trips to the Final Four.
Well, think about this. 91, 92, and 93. Three national championships. Whether you're down at Durham or you're here in Chapel Hill, you talk about two of the premier college programs in the United States of America, year in and year out. Great respect and admiration for each other.
Now it's a six-point lead.
Came up big on a free throw line. It's still a two-possession game.
Duke with the great three-point shooters.
We got to set a screen.
Quickly. Ojo's going to come through. Bangs it in. Zwicker, offensive foul. Out of control. Three trips in a row. Duke has not gotten a thing.
They got the Zippo sign, the three-ring Valentine sign. Zip, zip, and zip, the last ring. Wojo trying to attack and penetrate. There's Zwicker's stationary. He put his head down. Good job by Zwicker to take the charge at 7-3.
Shot clock is turned off inside of 35 seconds now. So Duke forced the foul in a hurry, trailing it by six. And a 20-second Dean Smith timeout.
Remember this, January 29th, since that day when they lost 80-73, North Carolina, they have not lost. And both clubs have been 15-1 since that day. Only a last-second loss to UCLA by Duke to bar the last 16 games.
And a reminder of what's ahead of us, the AC Delco Classic on ABC. That comes your way Saturday at 3 Eastern. The Pro Bowlers Tour goes to California. The World Speed Skating Championships are featured on Wide World, along with the NutraSweet World Challenge of Champions. That's Saturday at 4:30 Eastern Time here on ABC.
Look at Dean Smith smiling. I tell you, all he wanted to talk about before the game was Roy Williams, Eddie Fogler, and the jobs they have done. His former assistant coaches now doing brilliant jobs in Kansas and South Carolina.
And Williams ticking away with the clock, bringing seconds off. Cota, snap pass, Jamison, and he is fouled. Fouled by Newton, and Antoine Jamison steps to the free throw line with 25 seconds.
Well, good job reversing the basketball, but they could also backed it out and manage the clock and take a little bit more time off, because right now they didn't need points. They just got to take some time off, unless you're going to get the wide open jam. Because right now he's got to convert these free throws, and he's a 65% free throw shooter. Last year, he shot 62% as a freshman.
What a monstrous day he's had. 32 points, 11 rebounds. Now, there is a huge point.
That's major, major big. That might be, I just seen the bus driver running down the hallway. The bus driver's running down the hallway. He's getting ready to, yes, turn the engine on. Not turning it on yet. We're going to see one more possession.
Tap back to Jamison, and that's going to do it.
Yep, the bus driver just started the engine.
And here comes Kota. The freshman point guard steps up to the free throw line. 21 seconds to go now. And Carolina is going to wrap this up.
But don't count this guy out in the ACC tournament.
He has the number one seed, Dick, and he'll play the winner of North Carolina State against Georgia Tech. Wake has locked up the number two seed, and they'll play Florida State. That's a rematch of their loss last week. Rojo fouls out of the game, and he scored 18 points.
I'll tell you one thing. You got to respect and admire the effort of Wojciechowski. Quinn Snyder, Tommy Yamaka, former point guard, certainly could appreciate his effort to find assistance for Duke.
Remember this about Carolina this year. No team swept them in the ACC.
That's right. It looks like that will not happen. What a regrouping job. Certainly can make a case for Dean Smith as the coach of the year. I said whoever wins this game would be my choice as ACC coach of the year.
They started 0-3, Dick.
To the victor goes the spoils. Michelangelo should be the coach of the year in the ACC.
Final seconds tick away here. Carolina and Duke will have split two wars this year. Duke winning over at the Cameron. And Carolina returning the favor here at the Dean Dome in Chapel Hill. And who knows, maybe they will meet next weekend in the ACC final. Let's see how the brackets come out. See how that unfolds.
There's a look at Michael Chang. 17th season. It's been an unbelievable career. Winning 73% of his games. Second all-time winningest coach in the ACC behind Dean Smith as he passed Frank McGuire the other day. Plus, he has 39 NCAA tournament wins, 12 NCAA tournament bids. And on the other side, Dean Smith will have 23 consecutive years invited to the big party for the NCAA tournament. March Madness, Mr. Musburger. It is special, baby. Hey, this place was rocking last night with a high school game here. They had 10,000 fans from Mount Zion taking on Oak Hill. Mike Krzyzewski had a recruit in that game, William Avery, 24 points.
That's where the term March Madness started, is with the Illinois State High School Association.
Oh, really? I didn't know
absolutely,
that.
Absolutely, downstate Illinois.
Wow, thanks for teaching me that. Oh, listen to the crowd. Overrated, they're chanting. Don't you chant that. They're not overrated, baby. They're legitimate. They love getting on each other down here, I'll tell you. And also, the Cameron craze is the same with the heels, and that's what makes it so special.
Carolina wins it. Carolina and Duke split two wars this year in the ACC.
But don't forget, Duke won the ACC regular season championship. And to me, that should be recognized with the number one seed. That's more important to me than winning a postseason three-game tournament.
So that's going to wrap it up from Chapel Hill. For Dick Vitale, I'm Brett Musburger. So long, everybody.